गुड मॉर्निंग आदित्य, गुड मॉर्निंग आदित्य। हाँ गुड मॉर्निंग आर्यन, गुड मॉर्निंग दानिश, गुड मॉर्निंग प्रति, गुड मॉर्निंग रोशन, गुड मॉर्निंग चंद्रशेखर, गुड मॉर्निंग कुणाल, गुड मॉर्निंग उद्धव, गुड मॉर्निंग दिग्विजय, गुड मॉर्निंग एलरॉय, गुड मॉर्निंग अभिजीत, गुड मॉर्निंग रितेश, लेट्स रिकैप व्हाट वी हैव सीन इन यस्टरडेज सेशन। So we have gone through the first roundtable conference, which held in London on 12th of November 1930. It was to discuss the report submitted by Simon Commission, which had proposed self-government in the provinces and Federation, as well as the princely and the princely states at the center. So the proposal was going to discuss in that first roundtable conference, but it was boycotted by Indian National Congress. So though the first roundtable conference was boycotted by the premier political party called Indian National Congress, it was attended by representatives of Muslim League, Liberals, and some other parties. So it adjourned on 2nd January 1931 without the premier political party. Right. And then later on there had been Gandhi-Irwin Pact, by the initiation or initiating efforts of Sapru and Jaikar to bring the reapproachment between Gandhi and British government. So there had been six different meetings between Gandhi and Viceroy Lord Irwin. And on 5th March 1931, then Gandhi signed a pact, which is nothing but to call up the national movement and to be agreed to join the second roundtable conference. And as decided according to this Gandhi-Irwin pact, Gandhiji attended second roundtable conference on behalf of Indian National Congress, which was held at London in September-December 1931. And it was under the viceroyalty of Lord Willingdon. So at that time, there was the viceroy called Lord Willingdon. Further, no output have come out of second roundtable conference. And the economic or political concession was opposed to India, because if the political or economic concession is given, then obviously later on it would become a path for the independence. So conference failed, right? as Gandhiji haven't agreed with another proposal put by British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald, which was depended on communal representation. So the policy of communal representation was rejected by Gandhi, and you can consider a failed conference. So second round table conference was also failed. Now, the policy of communal representation. So what was the policy of communal representation, which was called as the communal award? It was also called as MacDonald Award. So which had come on 16th of August 1932. So British Prime Minister MacDonald announced this particular award, which was completely based on communal representation. So it was not only containing provisions to Muslim, Sikh and European electorates, but also electorates to the depressed classes. Right. So we're containing provisions to Muslim, Sikhs, Europeans, as well as the depressed classes. So depressed classes have been added in this. And because of this award, because of its declaration by Prime Minister MacDonald, Gandhiji deeply grieved and underwent a fast to protest against this particular award, because this award was aimed to divide the India on communal basis. So everywhere there had been mass meetings took place, and political leaders of different persuasions become active, right? Such as Madan Mohan Malviya, B.R. Ambedkar, M.C. Raja. So such kind of political leaders have become active by the fast of Gandhiji, right? Which was against, or which was to protest the MacDonald Award. And then again, there had been the pact signed in between the Hindu leaders and Ambedkar on behalf of Harijans. On behalf of Harijans. And that was called Gandhi-Ambedkar Pact, which was on signed on 24th September 1932. So communal award created immense dissatisfaction among Hindus. So according to this pact, the idea of separate electorates to depressed classes was abandoned, but the seats reserved for them in provincial legislatures as well as in central legislature have been reserved. So around 148 provincial legislature seats have been kept reserved, and of 18% central legislature, of 18% seats kept reserved for central legislature. So ultimately, then Gandhi ended the fast by signing Pune Act, right? And there had been the joint electorate for, right, on which Hindus and depressed classes agreed, right? So no separate electorate classes, electorates for the depressed classes, right? So this is what we have considered in the yesterday's session. Now we can consider the third round table conference, so which had been concluded on 17th of November to 24th of December 1932. So it was held in 1932, right? But again, it proved fruitless because the at the time of this conference have been taken place, the national leaders were in the prison. So national leaders haven't attended this particular conference, though it was conducted, right? That doesn't mean that national leaders means the most of the leaders from Indian National Congress. So it was proved to be fruitless. Right. It was proved to be fruitless. Why? Since national leaders were in prison. Right. And then probably in one of the previous sessions, I must have put a light on the Government of India Act 1935. Right. If not, then now you can consider, and it is not only being considered for history, but also it is the integrated part of the Constitution of India. So how the Constitution of India was based on this, the skeleton of this particular act. Right? So later on there had been the Government of India Act, right, 1935. Now see, you know the now background of Simon Commission report, which was submitted in 1930, and on the basis of that, now British government have formed the Government of India Act 1935. So in between these 5 years, there had been different discussions, there had been different conferences, and now it had converted into an act, right? So depending on the report of Simon Commission, the British government formed the Government of India Act 1935. So the new Government of India Act, that is the Act of 1935, received the royal assent on 4th August 1935, and it was continued and extended all the existing features of earlier constitutional reforms, but this time in addition to earlier constitutional reforms, there were certain new principles have also introduced, and these principles are nothing but the federal type of government, right? So according to federal type of government, what is going to be introduced? So it will be introducing provincial autonomy, right? So the provinces will be autonomous. Then it had abolished diarchy in provinces, right? Provinces madhe je kai rajgharane diarchy, right? So that was being abolished. And then there had been the ministers, right? There had been made ministers had been made responsible to the legislative as well as federation at the center, right? Even, you know, today also some of the departments, for that particular departments, the corresponding ministers are responsible, right? So that is the case you can consider in this Act, right? So the Government of India Act 1935, right? So it has abolished diarchy in provinces, right? Now, so in This act, as far as this act is concerned, now this act was condemned by nearly all the sections of Indian public opinion, and it was unanimously rejected by Indian National Congress. Unanimously, ek matana dhudkan lavla. Right? It was unanimously rejected by the Indian National Congress. So, Indian National Congress demanded itself the convening of a constituent assembly elected on the basis of adult franchise to frame the constitution for the independent India. Right? So, for this act, so Government of India Act 1935 was called as a new charter of slavery by Jawaharlal Nehru. So Jawaharlal Nehru's remark on this act was, it is nothing but a new charter of slavery, right? Nothing else. So whatever we are leaving, the same thing is there. Only thing is that the name will be changed, right? So earlier there had been only constitutional reforms. Now it will be called as the Government of India Act. Nothing else. So although the Congress opposed this act, it contested the elections when the constitution was introduced. That was on April 1, 1937, and formed ministries. So they have, step by step, they have expanded the formation of ministries. So in very first step, in 6 provinces, and in later on again in 2 provinces, they have formed their ministries. But in this case, Muslim League was not happy with the Congress rule, especially Mr. Jinnah, right? So he was against the ruling of Congress or the ministers of Congress, right, which have been elected or they have been contested the elections, right? This is the point you can always consider. So always keep in mind, the Government of India Act 1935 is nothing but the skeleton of even today's Constitution of India, right? So most of the things, right, the skeleton of today's constitution, right, are from this particular act. There had been 3 different points. So one of these is nothing but Government of India Act 1935. So whenever we will be going for Constitution of India, so at that time I will let you know. But since we have come across this particular act, then you should always concern about its relation with the Constitution of India. So based on report submitted by Simon Commission. Based on the report submitted by Simon Commission, British government formed the Government of India Act 1935. Government of India Act 1935. Right. So it was formed and it received parit hone pass jhala, received an assent, received an assent on 4th August 1935. Right. So, so what was this act? So it continued. Very first thing, it continued and extended. All jevade hote tevade sagle pude forward kele. It continued and extended all the existing features. All the existing features of earlier constitutional reforms. Constitutional reforms. Also, it added certain new principles. Kaita to tachat add keli. So what these were? If anybody wants, you can take a screenshot. Okay, done. Digvijay, okay, I will definitely share the screen. Don't worry. So, okay. So, what are very different principles introduced in this, right? So what this act is, so very first principle introduced is, so it introduced provincial autonomy. Provincial autonomy. Second thing, abolished diarchy in provinces. And second, last one you can consider, that is ministers made responsible. For what? To the legislative and federation at center. Federation at center. Fine. So this is what the brain and heart of the Government of India Act 1935, that you should always keep in mind. Now, what had happened? Act was condemned by nearly all sections of Indian public opinion. Indian public opinion. Right. And right. So unanimously rejected by INC, Indian National Congress. Right? So Congress haven't stopped just by rejecting the act, rather they demand it. Indian Congress itself should be convener, right, of a constituent assembly, right, elected on the basis of adult franchise to frame the constitution for the independent India, right. So I will write unanimously rejected by INC, and INC demanded, and INC demanded. So what INC demanded? So INC demanded itself the convening of Constituent Assembly. हे बघा, तोपर्यंत काय झालं होतं की आता भारताला स्वातंत्र्य द्यावं लागेल हा विषय, हा विचार पुढे आला होता. अँड इफ इंडिया इज गोइंग टू गिव्ह फ्रीडम, देन इंडिया मस्ट हॅव इट्स ओन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. आणि जर स्वतःची कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन असेल पाहिजे असेल तर ती फ्रेम करायला लागेल. सो ब्रिटिशर्स वेअर जस्ट itself the convener, right? So convening of constituent assembly, right, to frame a constitution.
Please try to join again. We'll open this session immediately for you all.